Good evening, WIFTA Universe. We are here for another night of roller derby action. We are in the Midwest as tonight's Capital City Crushers out of Topeka take on the Natural State Roller Team out of Arkansas. With me tonight, my co-host, to my right, out of the Capital City Crushers, Memphis Misfit.
I'm happy to be here. Thanks for having me, you guys.
And above me on the screen are the co-hosts tonight, Scott Chicken out of Seattle. How are you doing tonight, Scott?
I am doing all right. How are you guys? Thanks for inviting me over.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Hey, we're known in the Midwest Roller Derby for a lot of jumps, jumping tornadoes, jumping things out of the way.
I hope there's no like tornado warning coming up tonight. That would be it. I've seen too many TikToks of tornadoes recently. I don't need that in the middle of a roller derby bout.
We got some good weather here tonight. So have uninterrupted, amazing roller derby out for everybody.
Excellent.
Well, the good thing, too, is the arena, I think, is pretty soundproof. So even if the tornado alarms go off, I don't think we'll even hear.
No one will know. Perfect.
Well, I think they're going ahead with their national anthem, but we're going to go ahead and announce these amazing teams that are playing tonight. Yeah. Scott, if you'll take us with the visiting team, the Natural State Roller Derby.
I will. Skating tonight for Natural State Roller Derby, we've got number 0, Owie, 012, Brick Wallace, 07 is Bruise Cruise, number 11, Crystal Bala, number 12, Badger, 17 is Chocahontas, 1976, Cat Crash Fever, number 242, Frito Bandito, 316 is Star Platinum, 510 is Amazon, 7724, Heartless Hungarian, number 800 is Ghost, and 808, Holly Grail, and they are coached by Alex Lee and Allie Miller.
All right, excellent. Big team tonight, and our home team, Memphis Misfit, if you'll announce your Capital City Crushers.
It will be my pleasure. We have number 10, Spawn, number 117, Tara Tendon, number 15, Mini-Me, number 164, Miss B. Haven, number 25, Ruthless, number 35, Killer Whale Tail. Number 357, Lady Ricochet. Number 424, Steel. Number 504, Lone Ranger. Number 55, BB Bombshell. Number 68, Anhurism. Number 7, Cecilia Payne. Number 919, Celerity. Number 97, Pika Punch You. Number 99, Purple Rain. Number 505, Honey Basher is an alternate. We also have Luna Shovegood as an alternate. The coaches tonight, 242, Miranda T. Reaver, and number 45, Serial Killer.
Awesome. Should be a great bout tonight. And our officials tonight, head refing is going to be Jake from Skate Farm. Our other referees tonight are Zippity Doodon, Mayhem, Bionic, Gusha, Trauma Queen, and LP. Our NSO positions, Killmore Girls, Bad Carbs, Cursula, Michael Gilmore, Fabian Aguilar, Scarlet Oscaria, Papa Goose, Lucia Latou, I hope I'm pronouncing that one right, General Merciless, Stace Invader, and our camera crew tonight is Fire Red's mom, Red, another Capital City Crushers. Should be a great bout tonight. Scott, coming out of us in Seattle, what are you hoping to see tonight in the Midwest?
I was told there would be jumps. That was what I assumed from the jumping.
You did set them up.
I'm like, you did set me up for that. I'm just really vibing on the black light and the cool colors in this rink. It's pretty happening.
Yeah, this and a non-wood is, floor. This rink is a nice...
Right? They have a great floor.
Yeah, Memphis, you skated this floor several times. How is the skating floor at Skateaway there in Topeka?
So I love their floor. I feel like it's slick enough. You have a little control, but not too slick. I've skated on many floors that are very slick, and it's very hard to stop. So
is it like a painted concrete, or is it some sort of...
Yeah, I think it's a painted...
Yeah.
And I think we are about to actually start with our first jam of the night here. Woo-hoo! Capital City Crushers, Natural State. Whistles off, jam liners off the jam line. It looks like Capital City Crushers pushing ahead.
Steel got out. She's Almost. There she goes.
And Capital City Crusher is picking up lead jam.
All right, natural.
Really nice. Capital City Crusher is picking up that lead jam, first jam of the night, kind of getting that motivation, natural state. Now, also, out of the pack, both jammers have the ability to score.
Field's probably going to call it as natural state.
Right.
Very good.
And Capital City Crusher is looking to pick it up. Possible 4 points there. I think they might have called it before natural state hit the pack.
4-0.
Right on.
All right. We're currently lined up for the Capital City Crushers for natural state. I don't have a number. 0? Maybe Owie?
Could be. We'll see. If they ever get the numbers up. Like, let's see. So that's Celerity. Yeah. You got Celerity jamming for Capital City, City Crystal Balla, star for Natural State.
You got Cecilia Payne taken.
Memphis, we're seeing a little bit more defense here. Yep. What do you think?
The defense is working real well. We did just have a penalty called on the Natural States jammer, Owie. So now that Capital City Crushers has a power jam.
Yeah, Celerity diving through quickly. So you guys are doing sort of that, say, passive aggressive hangout, wait for the jammer to come in, sweep forward. A little slow.
Yeah, that is
sweep, but he's kind of moving through.
Yeah, I think she's pushing a little more than I'm sure she'd like to at this moment. But now the other jammer's released, so Capital City Crushers need to form their wall and get ready.
Yeah, in doing so, they look like they had a little bit of a goat trapped at the back, but not able to really capitalize pushing through. So good penalty kill by Natural State.
Right.
Giving up 4 on the power jam. Now Pack starting to break free and roll around. Is Celerity still looking to get through, but just held up. Nice little offensive bing by 68 and Heroism.
Yeah, I think that defense on Natural State starting to look at what Capital City's doing. I think they're going to start changing how their wall's looking.
Natural State's almost getting out of there. There it is.
Finally clears.
And that's when you call it.
You too. Like, oh, they're about to make some points. I'm just going to end that right now.
Now it's time to call it. That's right.
So
let's
10-0 run takes us to 14-0.
Two new jammers out on the jam line. Looks like Capital City's jammer. Trying to see their number, but jamming right up on the jam line. That wall start right up on the jam line as these jammers looking to find the hole. Jamming down for the Capital City Crushers, Mini-Me, and for Natural State, Star Platinum. And Capital City Crushers right off the bat, lead jam.
Both of them out of the pack quick, so it'll be interesting to see what happens when they approach the pack. Looks like Mini-Me's going for some points. Will she call it off in time?
Big crush there. Capital City calling out the jam. We'll see if either of these points. Teams pick up some points here. Looks like Capital City picked up 2 points, bringing Capital City 16, Natural State 0.
Oh, I thought Natural State would have picked up some points there. She was really going.
It looked like they were both in at the same time.
Yeah, she is impressive. That was great.
Just not quite caught off by the quick call off.
Yeah, the timing was great.
All right, on to jam number 4. Who do we got?
BB Bombshell for Capital City Crushers.
Excellent. And that's back to number 11, Crystal Balla. Jamming for Natural State, but lead jammer going to Capital City.
I think Capital City, they've gotten all the lead jams. I can't remember,
I think
they picked up all 3 so far.
Yes, they're 4 for 4. Crystal Balla clear as BB Bombshell dives through, and as expected, calls off the jam. I like the fact that the camera's like right next to the Capital City bench, so you can just see who's coming out.
You get to see those frustrations or those moments of triumph every time they kind of come in.
Yes, exactly.
Jammer down on the jam line, Capital City 20, Natural State 0. Jamming for Capital City is Luna Steele's her name? Just Steele now?
Steele.
Just Steele. Memphis, you've blocked against Luna. How does she jam? What's her approach when she's coming in that jam?
So Steele is swifty. She's going to be bouncing side to side and finding your open holes. So, and she's powerful. So she's going to push through, and right there, as soon as you leave it open, she's going to dominate that space.
So she picks up lead jam for Capital City. She'll be jamming against the number 0, Owie, for Natural State. Owie still in the pack there. Steve, what are you thinking as far as Natural State? What are they looking to trying to pick up this point gap they got now?
Well, I thought they were going to grab late jammer because Owie was really close, but that was some great one-on-one defense at the front of the pack to just slow things down and let Steele grab lead. And Steele picks up some points, calls it off, but Natural State did get two, which is intriguing because I didn't think they got out of the pack, but, you know.
Yeah, it was
points
quick.
Gonna point.
And,
so, yeah. Maybe that was the two from the previous jam that you were saying, hey, I think she got some points. That could be where that would come from.
They may have caught up, yeah.
And just said, oh, wait, we had two before. That's what I'll put on my head. I'll make the executive decision in my unofficial score log that that's where those points came from.
Oh, there we go. Natural State getting lead.
Hey, first of the game.
Yeah, and that'll be a good pickup for them. Capital City out of the pack now, too, but Natural State, star platinum in there. I can't tell. She had to pick up some points there, and I think she called it before Capital City got in there.
I believe she called it before Capital City, but I think she was down as she passed, so I'm not sure that she accrued points.
Yeah, it looks like 0-0 points there. Capital City 25, Natural State 2.
And official got time. Is it because the lineup clock is all weird on our scoreboard? You've still got 1,439 seconds, minutes to go. So you guys have a doubleheader coming up in June, it looks like. Oh, wait, we're back. Never mind. I hate these short official timeouts. I'm like, what are you doing? Come on.
I think they were just figuring out scores, but Capital City now right off the jam line. They're going to pick up lead jam. Looks like jamming again is mini me, but Natural State right behind them. It's going to be a race right to the pack. These jams have been super quick tonight. Do you think this is what we're going to see for the rest of the night?
The Capital City Crushers are coming out strong, but I think, you know, Natural State is starting to get the vibe and starting to read the packs a little bit. So I wouldn't count them out just yet. But both teams, both jammers coming out strong.
Yeah, it's definitely felt like a really good pace. Just a lot of super short jams. Nobody choosing to run it long quite yet.
Okay.
And we are back in with Owie. Jamming for Natural State, and what is that, 55 BB Bombshell, breaking out first for Capital City, grabbing lead. Owie still held in the pack as the Natural State defense getting ready for the return of BB Bombshell. BB into the back of the pack, engaged with the tripod. Owie finally pushes through the front to complete the initial. BB Bombshell Natural forced State out of bounds. No, go ahead.
They had some beautiful waterfall with their tripod just form, you know, rotating around through the left and the right. They call that a waterfall, and it was absolutely gorgeous. It was very effective.
Yeah, and looking like maybe holding BB Bombshell scoreless. So we're sitting 28-5, 20 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah, the both jammers have been finding a way out every time. No jammer's kind of been held up. Capital City now picking up lead jam. They're steel, but Both jammers, there hasn't been a holdup on a jammer yet. Jam's been real quick. Jammer's in and out, and jam's getting called off. And it looked like Natural State there was going to go for a pass, but she got out.
Yeah.
Both jammers don't have the ability to score. I'm surprised that's not more of a strategy once the other team gets lead, looking for that pass real quick. And if you can't get it, you're out.
So that is a strategy that most teams practice. As soon as the other team gets lead, the jammer is supposed to take off that panty and prepare for that pass. But when you prepare for the pass as a jammer, you never rely on that pass. So you're taking it off, but your goal is to get out of that pack. It's effective. Sometimes it's effective just to take that panty off and or helmet cover off and continue.
Yeah, always good to have options, I suppose, right? Like, you can't pass it if it's on your head.
Right.
All right, Celerity with the star for Capital City. Crystal Bella jamming for Natural State. Crystal Bella pushing to the front and out first. Lead jammer, second lead of the game for the for Natural State. First for Crystal Bella. Meanwhile, Celerity held up in the middle, forced to the infield, back into play, and Crystal Bella finds room on the inside shoulder, and one skater to beat, and does slide around.
Natural State really using this one, kind of getting those points. Yeah, we got a call out on the text from Megan Sam saying, "Go Capital City."
Did you see that panty pass from Capital Crushers? Successful panty pass.
Right. Yeah, did you catch who the pivot was? Oh, I like the or coming out. No, you're not. Jam's not done.
Oh,
we got a. I think there's penalty on. Yeah, penalty called on Crystal Bella. So we will have a power jam and another 47 seconds of jam time. As both teams now with 4 points. I like the idea of Crystal Bella running it long because you're behind. You want to get more points, and defense was doing the job. But it kind of falls apart when you end up in the box.
Yeah, that penalty is not going to help.
No, unfortunately.
I think is that Cecilia Payne, number 7 with the star now?
Yes.
I think that was what that shirt said, right? All right, Crystal Bella now out of the box. Currently trailing 8-4. Looking on the outside, finds... Oh, I thought they had room, but no, that was the blocker knocking things free. Nice. There, finally a jump. It was over somebody, but still, I'm going to count it.
It was a mini jump.
That was a necessary jump.
That was I'm not going to trip over you.
That was a jump of survival.
Exactly. All right, we're going to see. City, there's got to be more than 4 points, right?
Well, Capital City looked like they picked up 8. I thought Natural State picked up more than 4, but it's only showing on the clock 4.
Right.
Capital City Jammers now, number 15, Mini Me. And again for Natural State, number 0, Owie. Right off the jam line, both packs now trying to stop those jammers. Capital City Carter's trying to go to the outside. Owie to the inside, and Owie's going to pick up lead jam for Natural State.
Natural City been coming back with their lead jams.
Yeah, that's number 4.
Yeah. Third of the game, second in a row. Not bad.
Capital City picking up. That's 3 points. They're probably going to get 4 here once they get out, unless they call it.
There she goes.
Natural State's got the lead jam. And she had to pick up 4 points there.
And a star pass on the Capital City side.
Yep, looks like it's going to number 97, Pika Punchu. And Natural State going ahead and calling off that jam. We're at 47 Capital State, 17 Natural State. Capital City 47, Natural State 17. Getting the city and the state, those are two hard things that come out at the same time.
Right. So what's the distance between these two teams? Like, how far did Natural State have to come to get to Topeka?
It's got to be between 7 and 9 hours.
Yeah, Arkansas is definitely going to be 7 and 9 hours.
Goodness. That's like, that's a haul.
Yeah.
Good work. All right, we got BB Bombshell jamming for Capital City and 316 Star Platinum with the star for Natural State. Star Platinum finally clears BB Bombshell lead jammer and engaged in the pack. Now breaking out the front. Checks to the bench. Bench says, yes, please call that off.
Yeah. Quick four, get in, get out, and call that one off.
So that'll got roll.
Shout outs from N. Halabeen, Go Celerity. If you want to join us on the chat, Twitch TV, please join us. Give shout outs, comments, questions. Let us know, and we will hit them up in the stream. Jamming down for Capital City Steam and for Natural State. I'm waiting to see that number. Capital City 51, Natural State 21.
Let me see.
Again, Crystal Bella right off the jam line. Capital City going to pick up lead jam. Natural State, though, right behind her. Race back to the pack. I think we're going to get another quick 4 points and done.
Or less. Good job, yeah, Natural State, staying ahead.
Thank you, Megan, on Twitch for answering Laura Farquaad's question. Yes, Capital City is based out of Topeka.
Ooh, a Natural State with the 1 point steal, 3-2.
Yeah, still super close bout.
It is 53-24. That's not bad. And an official team timeout. Now I can tell you about your upcoming event. Capital City Crushers hosting a doubleheader on June 24th. Game one, Capital City Crushers versus Springfield Roller Derby. Game two, Salina Sirens Roller Derby versus Kansas City Roller Warriors. Tickets to the door, $12 for adults, $10 for children. And as a thank you for your service, tickets are half price at the door for military, active veterans, active or veterans, police, fire, and EMS. Check out the event coming soon on Facebook. So now I'll ask the same question. Springfield and and Salina and Kansas City, how much combined driving is going to be involved?
So Springfield's definitely got the longest drive. They're coming out of Missouri. Salina is about 2 hours out of Kansas.
Okay.
And Salina Crushers played a lot of matches. They're probably the closest. And then Kansas City, probably an hour outside. So three Kansas teams, one Missouri team. Well, Kansas City, you got to ask the person from Kansas City, because they're either going to tell you I'm from Kansas or I'm Missouri.
From Missouri, right. Yes. Nice. Yeah. Should be fun. Is it in the same venue, or do you guys have other
same
spots?
Same venue as tonight. They'll do that doubleheader there. Salina just got a new rink or a new play area, so they're starting to do some more bouts out there. Their old rink from COVID got kind of closed down. But we're back to the action now. Natural State jamming. Owie, Capital City's jammer, Celerity, both off the jam line. We're starting off Capital City 53, Natural State 24. And Natural State picking up lead jam. We're pretty even on those lead jams now for both teams. I think Natural State kind of came in. Natural State coming in and figuring out those walls. So now it's going to be head on head. How important is that, Memphis, kind of figuring out those walls?
I feel,
forearm for Allie.
Figuring out that walls are key. Most jammers come in the first couple jams, and that's what it is. It's just assessing your walls and figuring out a game plan, using the tools in your toolbox, as they say, to figure out what's best for the walls you're approaching.
Absolutely. And I think we're going to be switching jammers here.
Yeah.
Power jam for power jam.
Exciting.
With 53 seconds left on the clock, Owie now back out on the... Did anybody see what penalty was on the jammer there for Capital City?
I didn't catch that one, no. In fact, I was like, oh, she's going around. Nobody's blocking her. Oh, it's because she's out of bounds. All right. Didn't even notice.
Well, Natural State will be trying to use this opportunity with 30 seconds left in the jam to pick up points here. Owie pushing through and out of the pack. picking up another 4 points for Natural State. Celerity now out of the box. Both jammers on there. 20 seconds left. This will go down to the end of the jam clock. And Capital City now out on of their initial pass. Both jammers now have the ability to score. 6 seconds left on the jam clock. And end of the jam. Natural State closing that gap. We're going to have a close bout.
Yeah, I believe so. Okay. They play hard. And they... I think they're starting to figure out the walls for the Crushers. So they'll have their work cut out for them.
Yeah, slowly but surely narrowing it down. All right, back underway. Got that number 15. That is Mini Me jamming for Capital City. And I didn't catch the number of that.
She's jamming around four.
Yeah. We got a lead, whoever it may be. We'll see. Scoreboard a little slow to catch up. Oh, nice move through. Caught up at the front of the pack. Pushing against, knocked to the ground, chooses to call it off.
She kind of called it a couple seconds late there. I think Capital City picked up, oh, it looks like they only picked up one. I thought they picked up a little more.
Yeah. Takes us to 54. Oh, there we go. There's. Another, I think we're getting some points from the previous jam rolling in.
Got it.
Catching it a little late because I'm like, oh, it could have been a six. Maybe that was the second pass through. Either way, 34-54, 20-point game.
Nice. Well, looks like jamming now for Natural State, Crystal Bala, and Capital City's BB Bombshell. BB Bombshell trying to go to the outside. Makes it right on the line. She's going to pick up lead jam for Capital City. And shout out also on the chat from our old referee, speaking of Selena Bluebeard.
Yes.
And if you were guessing, Steve, yes, he does have a blue beard.
All right.
A wonderful ref representing the Midwest, for sure.
And both jammers now, Natural State out. Both jammers have the ability to score. Capital City in the pack. Capital City also picking up a penalty, calling off the jam. We're going to see if these points catch up here. Looks like 57 Capital City, 34 Natural State.
All right, reset. 8 minutes to go in the first period. Jam 17 coming up. This is, as you said, they've been going quick. Only a couple. Yeah. I think the only long jams have been the ones with double penalty or with lead jammer penalties. Yeah. All right, so that is 424 steel with the star for Capital City, and number zero Owie jamming for Natural State. Owie forced to the infield, has to recycle back and. Out the front, steal.
Oh, there it goes.
Grabs lead quickly. Owie also clear.
I feel like Steele and Owie's jams have been quick every time. Both of them out of the pack, like, immediately.
Yeah, there have been several where it's, like, just very rapid, like, quarter lap, half a lap apart, but coming in quick. So a 2-0 Capital City run, stretching it out now, 63-34.
So jamming again for Capital City, number 15, Mini-Me, and this other jammer for Natural State, I need to find her number because that's that jammer we were talking about before. Her last jam, she picked up lead jam. That might be Crystal Bala. Both jammers now off the jam line, pushing straight on the pack, and Natural State to the outside. That's going to actually be 3-1
Star Platinum.
Star Platinum. Yeah.
Get it.
Yeah. And now the clock picks up.
Scorekeeper had to wait and get in.
Right? But Star Platinum back in the pack. Star Platinum having the ability to score. Capital City's Mini-Me Still trying to get that pack or back around the pack and cap or natural state calling off the jam.
Beautiful jam by Star Platinum.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful jam.
Well, she looks like she's one of those jammers that gets out and like looks at the pack almost like the Terminator, just like targeting every hole. Absolutely. And saying, this is going to be my yes. route. This is how I'm getting out of it.
And making contact throughout the whole time, just bouncing off skaters.
All right. I think that's Crystal Balla jamming for Natural State. Didn't catch who your jammer is. That's seven. Is that Cecilia Payne?
Yeah.
Or is that Bombshell? I think that will look like a single digit. We'll see.
Cecilia Payne. Yeah, that's her.
All right. Well, meanwhile, Crystal Balla is out and is lead jammer. Cecilia Payne clears the pack. Jam called off.
That effective quick jam. 4 points in. Call it off.
And we will get a 4-0 now, 42-63.
And now jamming for Capital City, BB Bombshell. And I think out again is number 0, Owie for Natural State. We haven't seen a lot of penalties blocker-wise. I think there's only been 2 blocker penalties so far.
Same jam.
Yeah. Both jammers down off the jam line. Capital City to the front, Natural State to the rear. Both jammers just trying to kind of push through the middle of that pack. And it looks like BB Bombshell picking up lead jam for Capital City Crushers. I got to imagine jammers are feeling all right with these being quick jams. Multiplayer block called on Capital City's blocker. We were just talking about.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you can say you jinxed it. You've remotely jinxed somebody with the penalty.
And looks like Capital City going to go ahead and call off the jam. I don't think Natural State didn't pick up any points there. I got to imagine Capital City, I don't think they picked up any points on that last route too. 63 Capital City, 46 Natural State.
All right, resetting with under 4 minutes to go. Steel, we're in the star for Capital City. To wait on the Natural State.
Right, is it just me, or is this like the quickest half ever?
It's going super fast. Yeah, like one timeout, one official timeout, and one regular timeout. Nothing big. It's 316 Star Platinum, and out first is Steel to grab lead jammer for Capital City. A little slide around. Star Platinum held up at the back of the pack. Natural State not able to throw any offense because they got to get ready for the return of Steel. But Steel evades that block and grabs the points. Slides on through. That takes Capital City to 70. Star Platinum still just on the sled, pushing hard in the middle of the pack, but not getting anywhere.
It really looks like these jammers are kind of going, same jammers are kind of going against each other every time. It looks like we've got a pretty equal amount of jammers tonight, too.
Yeah, there was a period where Natural State was going like a 3 rotation, but they have added someone in. But yeah, it is bouncing back and forth. Steel now 12, third pass. This is the first third three pass jam of the game. And star pass from Star Platinum off to the pivot. I think that was Amazon number 510 because they were in the penalty box and conveniently stood up. So I'm sure Star Platinum was like, why did you get a penalty? I would like to hand off to you now and not have another 30 seconds. But 4 pass run, 16 points. Capital City stretching it out, 82-46.
Memphis, how nice would that be if the jammer could just throw the star to the pivot sitting in the penalty box. Say, hey, you got this now.
You're
when you
done.
Get out.
Yeah, as soon as you get out. Enjoy that 30-minute or 30-second rest because right. You're going to need it.
Jamming down for Capital City is going to be number 15 Mini-Me and Natural State's Crystal Balla. We got like a huge traffic jam going on here. Wow. Both jammers trying to make it through this massive pack.
Wow. And attempt to jump.
Yeah, Natural State now picking up lead jam. I'm still waiting for that tornado jump, though. We're in the Midwest. We need to show them that big jump.
I think you're going to have to visit practice and show us what that looks like. Wow.
And, well, there was a twist there.
I was going to say, okay, twist, I see.
Yeah. Twister. 4 points
that
there.
Was beautiful.
Twisty back through.
And looks like we've got something going on. There's a pack kind of getting together. Ref's calling. And we got a penalty, looks like, called on Natural State's blocker. Pass to, again, Cecilia Payne, but a Natural State looks like a call off the jam. 82 Capital City, 50 Natural State, still very close bout. Or 52 Natural State.
And time for one more jam as we're down to 30 seconds or so.
Steve, I'll apologize.
Ice cream truck?
Music in the background. Yes. Yep, that would be like, our ice cream truck. Went down the
like
road.
That sounds like an ice cream truck. Clearly, your weather is better than it is in Seattle. All right, 919 Celerity with the star for Capital City. Natural State's number 0, Owie. Jamming. And period clock is now down to 0, so we're on jam time alone. As new to the game, the jam will end when the jam ends in its natural way. Celerity picking up, I think that was a forearm penalty. So, Owie, clear on a power jam and lead jammer to round out this half.
Great opportunity for Natural State.
He's like checking with the bench coach, should I call it off? And they're like, no, there's a power jam. You got time. Let's go. Get some points.
Let's do this. And just like that. That was beautiful.
Nice little, assuming a little offense to open up the outside lane. Slips through. Celerity now on the feet, so under 10 seconds to go. Pops off the helmet cover. There was another little tiny hop. Jump in the corner. Oof. 8 points now for Owie. As Celerity released.
I think Owie said, I'm going to make the most out of this last jam before I go take a break.
Exactly. Of course, it goes and heads off to the party zone. In that far corner.
That is actually where they sell the alcohol refreshments, is in the party zone.
That's where it should be, I gotta say. So an 8-point jam to end our period. Natural State 60, Capital City 82. It's been a good game. It was starting off, I'm like, oh, yeah, you guys are going to run away with it. But Natural State finally figured some stuff out, it looked like.
Absolutely.
These are the kind of the best leads. Those quick jams where the score is tied together. You start seeing a lot of moves. Blockers start getting a little bit more aggressive because they're saying, I don't want to let those scores go in. That's kind of what we want to see.
I can see that being the best bout for announcers. Playing, I prefer that
right?
point.
You're not getting a lot of rest. And I'm like, are you really only taking 5 minutes for halftime? Because, wow, that's also not a lot of rest.
I'll let you answer that question, Memphis.
Yes, That is a short halftime, and it is pretty common for the Capital City Crushers. All right. So
you have a hard out in the rink.
Enough.
Well, I think we're probably going to let you go here in a second. Any last minute thoughts, Steve, Memphis? What do we want to see in the second half?
I want to see the score continue to be close. I love watching them battle it out and just play some solid roller derby on both sides. They're both doing amazing, and I want to see him keep it up.
Nice. Steve, what you want to see?
Same. Same thing. Yes. Just close and maybe see if Natural State can start mounting a comeback. Although, 30 points or whatever we are, 22 points, not insurmountable, but it is a definite lead. So,
well, you get that one right power jam, and that's it.
Yes.
Well, all right. With the fans, we're going to intermission here. We've only got a couple minutes, so I don't know if we're going to take a break here or we might take a break, but we only got a couple minutes, and then we're going to go back to the action. Capital City 82, Natural State 60.
Welcome back from that super brief break. You're watching the WFTDA live on twitch.tv, Capital City versus Natural City, or Natural State. See, and now I'm doing it too. Like, is it a state? Is it a city? Scott Chicken here with Donuts and Memphis Misfits. 5 minute halftime. I'm still blown away by this. So I always thought that like time. Ted was stretching it.
You know, being a Saturday night, they're ready to open up the rink.
Okay. That was what I was saying. I'm like, this has to be the rink saying you need to be out of here by a certain time. And then you guys like set your halftime based on cushioning for injuries and whatnot.
We want to respect that. So we just, we take a quick breather and we jump right back in.
All right. That's,
well, I'm excited totally for the second half. And Scott, I am really excited. That's and I'm going to say that again. Scott, who I called Steve for the first half, I am super excited for the second half.
That's fine.
Because I think that with the score this close, they're going to start pumping up the action. I think we're going to see more aggressive blocking, and I think we're going to see some jammers try some stuff to kind of get
absolutely those. And I think the second half makes or breaks you. There's teams who come back even stronger, and there's teams that kind of fall back. So I'm excited to what we see here.
Yeah, should be interesting. We shall see.
I'm taking an impromptu picture.
It's important to get those on-camera selfies.
Oh, yeah.
He's all about the selfies.
Let's see what I saw.
He's donuts. Everyone loves them.
All right, underway we go. Crystal Ball are jamming for Natural State. And what do we got? 424 Steel with the star for Capital City. And Steel out first, starting off the second half, the same way that Steel started off the first half, grabbing lead jammer.
Yeah, but that Natural State, they're right out of the pack, too. I think we're starting seeing these quick jams again.
Exactly. It'll be another super rapid run. And Steel calls off the jam, presuming 3 to 4 points or two. All right, sure. We'll go with two. What the heck?
Two quick points.
84 to 60. All right.
Well, it looks like we got GM in for Capital City, BB Bombshell, and for Natural State, number zero, Owie. Jam, that pack again starting right off that jam line. I've been seeing that a lot more. As more bouts I've watched this year, you don't see a lot of packs kind of move off that jam line. Why do you think that is?
So the newest thing a lot of teams have been doing is taking away that space from jammers. So even if the jammer falls back on the line, the packs are trained to swallow up that space right on the 5 second call. So I think that's why you're seeing it more and more, them on the jam line. They don't want to give the jammers that space as they get more agile and jumpy.
Both jammers now out of the pack. BB Bombshell picking up lead jam for Capital City. In the pack, ability to score points, Natural State now. Both jammers in the pack. Both jammers get points, and it looks like Owie's going to slip it to the inside and pick up four quick ones there. I think Owie kind of snuck through there for Natural State.
She really did, yeah.
Yeah. That was the classic stealth move. Like, oh, nobody's looking my way. Just going to cut in the inside and grab it.
Capital City calling jam. Both jammers picking up 4 points. Capital City 88, Natural State 64. Yeah, I don't even think anybody. I didn't even hear the other team call out like call it. No, I don't think anybody saw her coming.
And that's the best time as a jammer, when you notice, hey, they're not paying attention. So this is going to be great.
Nobody's looking at me. All right, back to it. That's 316 Star Platinum, I believe. Out quickly, grabbing lead. And we've got Celerity 919 jamming for Capital City. And they're both lead jammer according to the scoreboard. That's great. Wow. that's very friendly. I think maybe something didn't clear from the previous jam. Oh, nice little sort of mini bean dip there by Start Platinum to grab the points. Slides through. Calls off the jam.
I think and Start Platinum got all four. I don't know if Capital City picked up any there.
That was a beautiful bean dip or half bean dip, as you said, which I love on the outside line there. I wish they would do that for me at practice, but you seem to cover those lines pretty great.
All right. Jamming now for Capital City Steel, and looks like, I believe, That's Crystal Ball at number 11. Steel right on the outside. Going to pick up lead jam for Capital City. These jammers equal lead jams again. I think Capital City's up maybe one jam this half. And a pass made to Natural State. I don't know the number, but Steel packed through. Now 4 points there. Both teams have kind of been using those passes pretty well. Steel yes. calling off the jam for Capital City. Capital City 90, Natural State 70. Storm Cell 626 says Twinkle Toes. Who do you think she was saying Twinkle Toes for?
I'm going to say Steel. but we've seen a lot of great footwork from both these teams.
Oh, no. She's saying WIFTA, Natural State. WIFTA, Natural State.
Yes, yes. Get it, get it.
All right, a little hesitation on the camera, or maybe that's my hand. Who knows? But it's forward in time with number 15, Mini Me. Jamming for Capital City and grabs lead. Owie with the star for Natural State. Owie now star in hand and forced out. Nice little run back there. Drawing her back a little bit farther. As Mini-Me through for the first points of the jam, 4 points up. Yeah, now Owie is clear. Oh, no, that's... Yeah, they were showing star pass, but I think that was just Owie taking it off and putting it back on. So Mini-Me collects three on the second run through. Or make that four. All right, they just hadn't caught up. So 98 now to 71.
Jamming out for Natural State, star platinum, and first time on the jam line. She's taking a pass, but first time on the jam line tonight. Number 97, Pika Punch You. It's Pika Punch You, right?
Yeah. It is? Yeah.
And to ask my co-host here. Both jammers out off the jam line. Big pack there as they try to push through. Pika Punch You to the outside, trying to push through those jammers. And right behind her, star platinum. And star platinum picks up lead jam. Pika right behind. Both skaters now racing back to the pack. I think star snuck in there. I think Pika thought she had it. And then
I think so too. And then, you know, during that time when the jammers are so head to head, it's important for the pack to figure out if they want to be front and back. If your jammer's in front, it's more beneficial for your pack to be in the back. So maybe they can get a couple points as they come through, but that's not quite how it played out here.
No.
All right, away we go. Another little slow on the start, not quite as spread out as some of the packs we've seen. Both jammers rolling pretty well, though, is 55 BB Bombshell with the star for Capital City. But Natural State grabbing lead. I'm going to guess that's Crystal Balla just because of the order. Hey, I was right.
Yeah. No,
sometimes taking notes pays off. So, Crystal Balla lead jammer rolling back in and diving out. One blocker to beat does get passed for the first 4 points.
Yeah, that crusher blocker jam. Wanted to grab that jammer, yeah. But
just realized a little too far ahead of the pack. BB Bombshell all now clear. I'm only seeing 1 point for that pass, so not sure if there was some unearned points on that run or unearned pass on that run or not. But Crystal Balla calls off the jam. We'll see if there were any more coming out of that pass.
There we go.
All right. So total of 4, 75-98.
Jamming now, Capital City, Steel, and Natural State, 0. Owie, looks like Capital City there throwing the pivot right before the whistle. Both jammers now out looking for those holes. This one might be a fight. I thought it was going to go to Steel, but it looks like... Owie on the inside trying to get what recycled to the back of the pack. No lead jammer yet. Steel now picking up lead jam for Capital City. Owie right behind her.
That's
again.
Capital State right there.
Do you think when that happens, the other jammer is just like, hey, right behind you?
Do I think? I know. And then it's fun to try and catch up. You know, like, oh, okay, I'm going to get you now.
Looks like 1 point there, Capital City 99, Natural State 75.
And it used to be more exciting when the jammer was the point, because you'd race for that point.
Yeah.
Now the jammer's no longer the point. So
right.
There's a little less pressure there.
The old pointless jammer. It does make life easier for the arguing, at least.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, exactly. Mostly for the ref. 316 star platinum jamming for Natural State. I believe is that who do we have with the star for Capital City?
I think it's Mini Me.
Catch that. Is it Mini Me? Okay. Oh yeah, that would make sense. I thought I was like, that looks like an 11, but that can't be an 11. There's no 11 on the roster. 15, much more sense. And there it pops up on the scoreboard as they get closer to where the scorekeepers are. Full lap with no lead jammer.
Wow.
And finally, Star Platinum comes out and grabs lead.
Those blockers have a full minute blocker now.
Like a fast jam.
Yeah.
They're all going fast.
And a star pass on the Capital City side, passing off to number 7, Cecilia Payne. And Star Platinum calls off the jam. Must have had some points. Ooh, just one. Good work, Capital City, staying ahead. Holding that to a single point.
I think she got that recycled, and she was like, nah, I'm going to call this.
Yeah, exactly. You know, get the pass, get it out, so they have to start focusing on the defense.
All right, jamming down for Capital City, number 919, Celerity, and I believe that is number 11. Crystal Bala for Natural State. Jammer's now off. Looks like Celerity is going to cut to the inside, up to the front of the pack, picking up lead jam for Capital City. Capital City also picking up a penalty on blocker number 25, Ruthless.
Great offense there by Natural State, getting their jammer out.
Natural State, both jammers down, off, out of the pack. Both jammers now have the ability to score. Capital City picking up 4 points. They have lead jam, and they're going to go ahead and call it. We're going to be at 103. Capital City down to triple digits, and Natural State not far behind at all with 77. Mm-hmm. 18 Natural points. State. What do y'all think? What has Natural State got to do to catch this score?
Keep getting lead, and I think that's you got to tighten up the defense, right? Like they're getting lead, but they're not getting many points out of it. So
right,
that's kind of the hook.
Yeah, push that other jammer to
Natural State slowing down the pack. If the blockers can slow down the pack.
Yes.
They can monopolize on those points.
Yes. Truly. BB Bombshell, number 55, jamming for Capital City. Natural State sends out number 0, Owie. And we slowly work around to the far side of the track, conveniently located through a whole bunch of people.
And both Baby Blue 68 hoping for Natural State. Big shout out. Come on, Natural State. You have this from on the chat from Baby Blue 68.
Well, they don't have lead because BB Bombshell has secured that finally. Full lap into the pass before grabbing it and almost a full minute. Oh, nice little shoulder. Owie thought they were free, but no. As the boom lowered by Capital City.
There's a reason they call that a soul crush.
Yes. Oh, totally. All right. This time, Owie looking somewhere on the outside, but still held up. Great, great work rolling forward by Capital City. Like, even if they're not making a shape, the individual blockers just coming up and continuing to get in front. And stymie Owie has been really good in this jam. BB Bombshell finally clears. Picking up.
This jam's going a little bit longer. Another shout out to Baby Blues. They can still catch up.
They can. Absolutely. It's true. Only a 28-point game at this point. BB Bombshell through for a 4-point second pass. And Owie still trapped in the pack as we're ticking down. This will be a 2-minute jam without a jammer penalty. Unless, you know, somebody gets one right now.
Called it.
No, I think, yeah, I think we finally had a Star Pass right at the end there. Maybe. I thought I saw Amazon holding something.
Yeah, looks like it.
Just never quite completed. Is that Amazon calling for an official review, or was that just stretching out? Yes, official review. I'm like, I think official I see review. Some official review hands coming up. All right, they did adjust that first pass to 4 points.
Yeah. I always think it's fun on the broadcast trying to guess what is the official review.
Well, you know, I saw some confusion at turn two, and I'm wondering if something along the lines there. But it looks like there might have also been a penalty involved, so perhaps that's what it was about.
Yeah, Amazon just sat in the box, just like right there below the logo. You can see your hand or whatever, but... So I wonder if it was like illegal Star Pass penalty being called and they want to wave that off. I don't know.
Yeah.
Don't know.
Well, I thought I saw a Star Pass at turn two and then I was wrong. And then a little later, Amazon did have the helmet cover. So I'm like, when did they do it? That was pretty impressive
because
I was looking for it. Yeah.
I got to imagine you're right. Because if they, you know, calling these official reviews, unless it's really going to affect the game, there's kind of no point in it. And losing that blocker is going to be a big effect for Natural State trying to catch up.
Exactly. They got 16 minutes. It also gives you a breather. So,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's never bad. So 33 points. I think a few good jams. That's that can definitely be caught up.
I was comfortable
until there's about a 60-point lead.
Right.
Then I'll
right, although, Natural State hasn't had, I think the only really long, high-scoring jam we had was from Capital City with, like, 16 points. Everything else has been in that 1-2-pass kind of range. So it will be a fight.
Natural State is going to have to stop Capital City's jammer. That's going to have to be their big thing. And they can slow down that jammer and allow their jammer to pick up those points. That's the only way they're going to do it.
Oh, and I think maybe we've got a power start. So maybe the penalty was on Amazon after the Star Pass.
Wow.
Yes, there we go. Because I was maybe the helmet cover as he was tossing back to the bench was the pivot.
Ooh, a quick power jam there. Steel jam for Capital City. She's picking up lead jam right off the jam line. She saw that line on the outside and she took it. Steel now going to try to make the most effect of this, picking up 4 points there with a quick turn on the inside. Natural State's going to have to do some work. Are they down to three blockers or they got four blockers? They have four, yeah. And Megan Sam on the chat saying Steel is a goat and calling it there with another 4 points is Natural State's jammer now out of the box. Amazon, that power jam is going to end right now. Capital City, 8 points in that jam. Call there by Steel. That's going to bring them up. Capital City 119, Natural State 78 with 15 minutes left in the half. This is another quick half, right?
Yeah.
Probably not as quick as the first one.
You know, it's interesting. Playing, I always feel like the first half is so long and the second half flies by. This is actually opposite. The second half is going a little slower for me, but the first half flew by. So that's interesting.
All right, back to it with both jammers starting off on the track at this point. And I didn't catch anybody's numbers as we rolled it. Oh, that's 919. There, I can see that one. Celerity with the star for Capital City. And out first and lead jammer is Natural State. Brick Wallace jamming, I believe, for the first time.
I think you're
at
right.
At least is starting as jammer. Number 012, they had a star pass earlier in the early in the half, but, you know, Natural State, like, you got to do something, see what happens.
Yeah.
Oh,
14 minutes left. Change it up. Quick.
Yeah, interesting choice calling it off there because I don't believe that that Celerity had gotten out of the pack yet. You'd think you could have stretched that and tried to add another run, but as it is. I'm assuming 4 points up, although they haven't shown on the board yet. 5 seconds! And we're 13:45.
Capital City. Yeah, there's those 4 points. Jamie Duff for Capital City, BB Bombshell, and for Natural State, looks like, number 11, Star Bella out of the pack. Star Bella has lead jam, BB Bombshell right behind. Oh, Crystal Bala is number 11.
Yeah.
There's a quick call up there. Zero, no points on the board. Capital City still 119. Natural State 82.
That was a great, great break free and force the call off by BB Bombshell. That was executed to perfection.
Yeah.
5 seconds! Baby Blue 68 says there is always hope. And yes, absolutely.
True indeed.
I love the enthusiasm.
Yes. Steel. Enthusiastically grabbing lead jammer.
Stealing that hope, Steel.
Steel trying to be a hope crusher. Oh, just bumped enough out. I was like, did you keep the feet in bounds? It's a lot of spinning. Owie, star in hand, forced to the outside. And again, soul crushed farther back. As Steel bumping to the in, but again, good. Waterfall forward by Natural State, trying to stay in front, but Steel finally out the front, picks up the points, and again calls off the jam. Now, as the team in the lead, totally makes sense. You burn 30 seconds off the clock, you got your points, mm-hmm. You're continuing to creep that lead forward. Now, 123.
I'm going to have to get those jammers too. Them knowing when they're out and when they're in, I could never do that. I could barely turn around skating, but them like knowing they're on that line, knowing they're out, need to be recycled. That I can never understand that.
Man, honestly, statistically, me neither.
All right, Jamie down for Capital City, number 919. Celerity and Natural State is again Brick Wallace for second jam, and Brick Wallace picking up lead jam. That's the second lead jam Brick Wallace has gotten. Mm-hmm. I think we know where all that hope is coming from. Baby Blue 68 is known as Mama Purr, and Purr 777 is her daughter playing tonight.
Ah.
And Natural State going ahead and calling off the jam. Natural State picking up 4 points there. Capital City 123, Natural State 86.
Official time.
Sam. From the chat says, Goldie loves y'all. I miss playing against the former juniors in Topeka. Always a great time. I believe that's Fire Red.
Oh, yeah?
I think that might be Fire Red in the chat. Former player in Capital City and former junior players for their Topeka team.
Shout out to Celerity's mom in Seattle.
Oh, wow. So Topeka mom out where you are, Scott.
Yeah. All right. Enjoying this cloudy, chilly day. Classic Seattle April.
Classic Seattle.
Yes. All right. 123-86. Just under 11 minutes to go in the game. Capital City up by 37. And they are sending out. Let's see. Who's that? Crystal Bala jamming for Natural State. Is that Pika Punchu, the star for Capital City? All right. I was like, I thought that was a 97.
Trying to punch,
that
was a great punch run on the
Yeah, exactly. I'm like, that was a bold attacking slice on the outside. Didn't quite work out, however. Crystal Bala is the lead jammer.
Wow.
And Pika Punchu is finally clear. Crystal Bala grabs the four, calls off the jam.
Jammer from Natural State just flying through that pack.
Yeah.
Yeah. But again, calling off. Go ahead.
I was just saying, I think you look at why that score is so close. You know, defense is doing well, but you really got to give those Natural State jammers for making sure that Capital City's not running up the score.
Yeah, exactly.
Jamie Nell, Capital City. BB Bombshell trying to cut to the outside, getting knocked back by Natural State. Natural State's jamming Owie. Star off the helmet, looking to try to possibly make that pass, but there's not a pivot in sight. Both jammers are still trying to push on that pack. Capital City will be the only one to be able to get lead, and BB Bombshell now picks up lead. Natural State get recycled, and Natural State blocker picking up a penalty. There's that Natural State pivot. I knew they had a pivot somewhere. I think Owie was looking for that pivot too.
She was, and she had a great inside jump. Didn't land the landing, but beautiful effort. Helmet pass or helmet cover pass.
And BB Bombshell in the box. That's going to give Natural State a power jam here, Star to Star Platinum. Perfect opportunity to put some points on the board here. We just got 46 seconds left in the jam.
Star Platinum, great momentum coming into the pack. It was just stopped cold.
Yes.
Oh, just there we go. Just a huge shoulder.
Find a way on the outside, picking up another 4 points for Natural State.
Hopefully they can.
Both jammers now back on the track. Power jam ends. 18 seconds left in the jam. Both jammers are going to try to push through to pick up last couple points on this jam. Both jammers now squeezing out of the pack, picking up another 4 points. Both teams looking like they're probably going to pick up 8 points for this jam.
I love it.
Capital City 131, Natural State 98.
I thought we were about to see some jammer on jammer action.
Yeah. So, yeah, I can tell Star was turning around like, okay, the jam's almost over. I'm going to go back to the bench, or I'm just going to knock her down just because I can.
I was immediately so excited. I was like, I love it. Let's do this.
Got some corrections on the chat. Baby Blue says her skater, her daughter, not skating night, she skates with Black or the Rough Riders. And Megan Sam, just a former junior. And a few who are also on the Junior Olympic team with her.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah. Good times, Junior Olympics. That was an entertaining tournament. Brick Wallace, lead jammer for Natural State, Celerity, number 919 with Star for Capital City. And Brick Wallace grabs some points, gets knocked to the infield, calls off the jam. We'll see what the total was. Two.
Two.
That takes Natural State to 100. Now a 31-point game.
Brick Wallace six and a half in, minutes to go. Making an effect on that jam.
Yeah.
Oh. And jammer's stalking there, realizing, there's the whistle jamming down for Capital City. 424 steal, picking up lead jam for Capital City. And number 11, that's Barbella. I'm not sure which one.
Crystal Bala.
Both jammers out quick. Steal in, calling off the jam. She was hit to the outside. Let's see how many points she picks up there. Looks like just two. Capital City, 133. Natural State, 100.
Yeah, that was a fun little start at the jam where like everybody missed the whistle. Steele's like, I'll just take advantage.
They were having a great time. Yeah.
They were trying to talk about where the after party was.
Yes.
That's important information.
And another slow run is Owie jamming for Natural State. And BB Bombshell, one to beat, is through in his lead jammer. Owie held at the back now, grabbing for the helmet cover. Amazon the pivot in pretty decent position, but Owie forced out of bounds again as BB Bombshell back into the pack, rolls through, grabs 4 points.
Two penalties on Capital City blockers. I think might have been a little directional there on Natural States jammer.
Yeah, but yet BB Bombshell able to break through quickly. Owie also, but BB Bombshell playing the I'm going to kill this penalty time. As long as they're going to lay you through, you might as well just burn some clock and get your people out of the box.
Super.
Owie, quick run through. Clears first. BB Bombshell forced to the infield. Has to recycle back. Now, Capital City's penalty box emptying out. Everybody back to full speed and full strength. And just random knocking downs, and somebody's going to the box. Like, that might have been even after the whistle. And Heartless Hungarian a little slow getting up, but kind of stretching out, and I think we're going to take it. Yeah, like, that looks like a kind of awkward landing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the landing, kind of landing on your own skate. That's, I have enough trouble getting up with shoes on, let alone with heels. This is why I talk about the game and don't play.
It's a lot of nice talking. I used to ref and that was okay, but sitting down talking about the game, probably one of my favorite places to be.
It's pretty good.
How are you doing tonight, Memphis? Not being on skates in the seat now?
I'm sure people can see my facial expressions and I'm trying to keep everything inside, but everything wants to come out. I got to give credit to the EMTs that show up to every bout, allowing us to play the sport safely, and their response time and being able to help us out when we are injured is just invaluable. So hopefully it's something small and she recovers quickly. That's always the hope.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Indeed. Hey, I'll do a plug for the remote studio. If you have a league and you're looking to broadcast your game without the expense and hassle of traditional streaming, like this game, which I think isn't that they're using like a cell phone to broadcast this?
Yeah, pretty it's cool. Just an Android phone on a tripod following the skaters around.
Right on. Well, the remote studio can get your games to a global audience with as little as a smartphone, as you are seeing right now. No matter your location or budget, get streaming with the remote studio contest broadcast at quadmedia.tv and check out the Broadcasting for Beginners resources at wftda.tv. And I missed it when the bot dropped it into the chat earlier, but if you're watching us on YouTube, you can, you know, like and subscribe and whatnot. And you can also subscribe for free if you have Amazon Prime. Just click the little how to subscribe with your Prime thing.
Getting a big hand for the skater there. I will say this, doing these kind of broadcasts, probably one of the best promotions a team can do to get your team out there, get people who usually can't see. I mean, heck, we even got a mom who's got a skater in Topeka and she's in Seattle. Gives her a perfect way to watch the team and get the name out there.
And then you get and all the moms
representing.
Right. It's important to get mom get the moms rolling out. These games do show up again later on YouTube. So if you're watching in the future on YouTube, hit the thumbs up, like it there. That really helps out. And then, you know, if you're skating, you can come back and watch. Do you guys do Memphis Misfit? Do you guys do like tape review later? And
yes, or just... we do bout rewatches, tape review, and just continue or move forward with design practice to work on what we see was not effective or monopolize on things that were effective 100%.
Or to even show the announcer who, Scott, you're not the only one, because the first game I broadcasted, I accidentally called Celerity General Merciless for like the entire first half of a game. And they brought that up in the viewing on the next day.
Nice. I was going to say, was the chat exploding on you?
No, I would have loved it if the chat exploded on me, because then I could have been like, I have been calling the wrong skater
the entire game. Yeah, especially some things are so much easier when you're in person, right? And that is one trick with the remote studio for the broadcast. It's like, who is that again? Like, I'm squinting at my screen, like, who am I looking at?
All right, we got jamming now. Looks like for Capital City, number 919. Speaking of Celerity jamming out there on the inside, it's going to pick up lead jam for Capital City, and Brick Wallace also out there out of the pack. Race back to the pack on another with probably going to be quick jam. That's a nice little sweep there from Celerity. Definitely picking up some points. Let's see if Brick Wallace picked up points before the call off. Natural State picking up 2. Capital City picking up 4. We're now Capital City 148. Natural State 114. And in the chat, you're right, Memphis. We got proud Derby moms.
Yes.
Cheering on their skaters.
Number one fans.
Very important. All right, 3 minutes to go. 34-point game. And number 1-1, Crystal Balla jamming for Natural State, but out first. Beautiful. And lead jammer is Steele, number 424, the previously named GOAT. And Steele is rolling in on the scoring pass. Crystal Balla catching up quickly. Steele does hit the hips, calls off the jam. Crystal Balla looked like that might have been pretty close to getting into the pack. We'll see.
Yeah, she's swooping it through the back.
Yeah. Well, maybe not. 0-0 at this point. Which, again, you know, tie jam goes to the team that's in the lead anyway. Oh, there's three up for Capital City. So, yes, getting the call off in time.
All right, jam whistles off. We got jamming now. Capital City, BB Bombshell versus Natural State's Owie. BB Bombshell in the front trying to push there, but good blocks from Natural State's Wall there, holding off Capital City. Is Owie, number zero, trying to push the inside, but BB Bombshell's going to pick up. Looks like BB Bombshell picks up a cut track on the inside. That's going to give Natural State power jam. And BB Bombshell did not get that lead jam. Owie now for Natural State has lead jam. Going to try to pick up some points. Do we think Owie's going to call this a little early to give them a power jam on the next one or just push for points?
If I were her, I would push for points. She's doing well. She's effectively getting around the pack, so I would just push through for those points. And it looks like BB is back in.
Yep. End of power jam for Natural State. 50 seconds left in the jam. Both jammers trying to push through. Looks like Natural State is going to push through the front for another set of points, but big hits there by Capital City. Capital City picking up a penalty on their blocker. I don't know. Has BB Bombshell made it on initial pass? Can Capital City score right now? Or I don't know if they've made it on their actual initial pass.
I'm not sure when the penalty hit.
Out of the pack.
Let's see. Yeah.
On the penalty.
Yeah. Ref is waving. Oh. Yeah, I don't think she picked up any points there. Capital City calling off the jam. Or Natural State, sorry. Natural State calling off the jam. Natural State, nice, picking up 8 points there. Natural State now 122. Capital City 151. This 30-point gap has held this entire bout.
Let's see if we get another jam. Is anyone calling a timeout? I don't think they are. The jam timer seems to think we're still going, even though the game clock is okay. There we go. I'm like, you gotta look at your. The internet knows the game's over. What the heck? That was a solid game. I like, as you said, the Capital City built that lead early on, and then they just kind of were able to maintain. And Natural Straight was starting to mount a comeback, but then that last the last five jams, I think you guys, Capital City had a lead for like four of them, and that just kills your chance of momentum on the comeback.
Yeah,
I don't think that 30-point difference. I think it held through almost the entire. I mean, up and down a little bit, but those jams were kind of on point every time. Quick jams in and out, whether it was Capital City or which was Natural State, and Capital City picking up a couple of those bigger jams at the start and a couple of bigger jams here, kind of put them in the lead.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. You guys, like you said, stepped out by what jam 10? I had 44-9, I think, and then you just sort of held that for the rest of the game, which is. Solid strategy.
What are they talking about Tuesday's practice?
I think offense. I think I saw some opportunities for offense. I think a couple times our sweeps weren't as effective, but we've been working on that. So I think that'll continue as well. But overall, I think my crushers did fantastic.
Yeah. It felt like both teams could have used a little more offense. There were a lot of times where it's just like Jammer's pushing on things and nobody breaking free to help. But that's...
Yes.
Being a non-skater, I look at that and go, that's got to be super hard, right? Like, what am I, what am I defending? What am I not? And,
yes, it is. Trying to transition from that offense to defense is very challenging. But...
All right.
Something to continue to work on.
Yeah.
Yep.
Any last minute thoughts before we get out of here?
No, it was a good game. Fun talking with you guys.
Absolutely. I thought Natural State was so consistent throughout the whole time. Like their players did not stop. Great stamina. It was great watching them.
Well, Scott, thank you for joining us tonight all the way out from Seattle. Thank you guys. Really appreciate it. Memphis. Thank you for being on the mic tonight.
My debut as an announcer.
Yeah. Scores to the dark end. Side. Capital City 151, Natural State 122. Thank you for being with us tonight with the universe. Keep it classic.